Let's see. What, let's just talk about the answers that we got. If we got anything from each other.
Mm-mm. I got two-thirds.
Two-thirds. Anything else? Any other answers?
0.66 repeated.
What's that equal to?
Two-thirds.
Two-thirds.
It's the same thing.
You got one half?
Yeah, I don't know.
Anything else? All right, how about the second one? Alright, let me remind you that last time we did these, we got things like two-thirds, but also six. Some people got six. And we got 288 last time, but some people got two.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Why is that? Why are we getting different answers?
It didn't have the correct
answers. So why does that make a difference? Before I put the parentheses here, how could you get six?
There's no idea.
Right? 3 divided by 3. So you do 3 divided by 3 first, which is 1. And 6 divided by 1 is?
6.
Yeah, but why would you do 3 divided by 3 first? Because
yeah,
there is no parentheses.
Left to
right.
Not
right to left.
Okay. Why would I do it left to right instead of some other way? Good.
Because that's the way you've been told.
Order of operations.
That's the way we were taught to do it.
Order of operations.
Okay. Why were you taught that?
We don't know. We were just taught that way.
Great. Yeah.
Okay. I guess just doing things because that's what you're told. Ever wondering why? Yeah.
Yes, because we read left to right.
Okay. So what I'm getting at here, and that's a good point, a good idea,
yeah,
is that it started somewhere. It didn't. It's not just true. Okay. What I'm trying to get you to see is that the right answer is not right because it's the right thing. Because it's just truth, like gravity is true, right? Nothing you can do about gravity. You can't decide things about gravity. Gravity is what it is. 2 plus 2 is 4. And there's no arguing that. 2 plus 2 things and 2 other of the same things are 4 of those things. But 6 divided by 3 divided by 3, without parentheses, can be confusing. And it's not a bad thing that it's confusing. Whether or not you divide the 3 by the 3 first or the 6 by the 3 first here is the result of some decision that you have to make, okay? There's no reason, just because numbers are the way they are, that we should divide one by the other first, okay?
Yeah.
So, in this case, this is not always the case in math, 2 plus 2 is 4, and if you get 2 plus 2 is 5, that isn't correct. In this case, we got 2 different answers because we went 2 different directions with it. Everything we did was correct. 3 divided by 3 is 1. 6 divided by 1 is 6. The problem with that is we can't just be doing it however we want. and just all getting different answers, right? All getting different results. How did I get you to all get the same answer just now?
You put parentheses.
Parentheses, okay. Now, did you do the parentheses first because parentheses in PEMDAS comes first?
Yeah.
Yes, and
you
go left and right.
If you knew nothing about parentheses, would you have multiplied this 2 by this 9, the 2 in this parentheses with the 48?
No.
No.
You would have done that?
No.
I believe that's true. I believe that you would not have done that. I believe that if I put parentheses around it, because parentheses are this grouping symbol, we just group things with parentheses, you would naturally, even if there were no PEMDAS, just do the things that are in the parentheses together, right, and work your way out if there were several parentheses. You just work it on down the line that way. Okay. So we could get rid of PEMDAS if we wanted to, right?
No.
How would we get rid of PEMDAS? What would we have to do then?
Take away the parentheses.
We'd have to guess, because we don't have anything that told us what to do first.
If I put parentheses around everything like I did here, were you guessing then?
No.
Right. By putting parentheses there, I know that you know that I want you to do these things together. These, and then do these, right? And then you have two numbers, and multiply this number by this number. If we're not confused about it at all, we got parentheses, and that tells us what to do first. Not because of PEMDAS, not because P stands for parentheses, but because we know what parentheses mean in general. They group things together. So I ask again, if I wanted to get rid of PEMDAS, what would I have to do then to make sure everything got done in the order that I wanted you to do it? Not the right order, just the order that I meant for you to do it. Yeah?
You can do if you wanted to do that, then you could just do first step. So if you write it down, it's 1 by 48 minus 2.
So list it out.
So
I can just
times the answers to
I can just say do step 1 48 divided by 2, right? I can do that. And then I can say step 2, kind of say bring this down, whatever you get there, multiply that. Maybe I should go like this. Step 2, do 9 plus 3. Right, do that for step 2. And step 3 is this thing times that thing. You could do that.
Yeah.
Crazy, right? That would take a lot of thought, a lot of working that out. Can I do that by saying, just put parentheses around things, just like I did? Okay. If I put parentheses around every pair of numbers that I wanted you to combine, do you think there'd be any confusion?
No. Not at all.
I don't think so. You can be very clear what it is that I want you to do first. I want you to do these things first, and there's parentheses inside parentheses? Well, do the inside parentheses first. Yeah.
What happens if we have 48 divided by 2 times 2, but you had parentheses around 2 times 2 divided, and then had parentheses around 2 divided by.
So we get a blank thing, and you can 48 divided by
2.
2.
Times 2.
Times 2.
Divided by 2.
Divided by 2.
So what happens if you had parentheses around 2 times 2?
And
2 divided by
48,
does that work?
2 divided by, you're changing it to 2 divided by 48?
Yeah.
Okay, what about it?
No, I would say 2 divided by 2 are still added into there too. I mean 2 times 2.
Yeah, oh my god.
So if you have 2 divided by 48 with parentheses.
What are you talking
here?
About?
Okay. Oh my god. No. So what happens if you had 2 times 2? Parentheses around.
2 times 2, parentheses around it.
Alright. No. If you had 4.
Kyler, just go
like six numbers and you have parentheses around the two outside ones and on the inside ones.
What?
I need some.
I don't know. You guys.
Can you come write?
Yeah. Well, I'm.
Can you write it with this? You can write it up there or whatever you want. There?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't
know. Go ahead. You can erase that if that's not what you meant.
Yep. I'm trying to think this through.
Yeah, sure. These aren't easy to come up with.
You just pop out your head.
Pretending there's no PEMDAS, I would look at this and I would say, well, 2 divided by 2 is in parentheses together, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh.
So I know I want to do 2 divided by 2, right? I think you want me to divide 2 by 2.
Yeah.
That seems pretty clear. So I can at least do that. 2 times 1 times 48
but
divided
then,
by 2.
Then I forgot to add in the parentheses on that.
Oh, whoops. You're doing it too. Do the undo a bunch of times. It's pretty cool. There you go. Okay.
Yeah.
Looks good.
All right, and then I had.
You forgot a parentheses?
Yeah, and I had it right in here.
Oh, well, why don't you put like brackets
Tyler,
around
what
it?
What are you doing?
Well, even better. Okay, so I've done the 2 divided by 2 is 1. That's where that comes from. And the 48 divided by 2, now I know that you want me to do that.
So 24, right?
So 48 divided by 2 is 24.
And then you times that all up, what do you? Yeah, you done what?
Yeah, now I'm not sure which one you want me to do first. The thing is, it doesn't matter which order I multiply these.
Just go left to right then?
Left to right, right to left. 2 times 24, then times 1, it doesn't make any difference. Multiplication's like that. Right? Multiplication does not make a difference what order I multiply things in. It's called the associative and commutative properties of multiplication.
I thought it was like, if you, it would get a different, really different answer than if you had 2 parentheses.
Well, with these 2 parentheses, Kyler, you have made it impossible for me to do it any other way, right?
Yeah.
Even without PEMDAS, if I put a parentheses around every pair of numbers that I want you to combine, you know, before you put it with other ones, then there's no way for me to mess it up, unless I make an arithmetic error.
Yeah. See, I thought you would come out to a like really big number, but
well, whether or not it's a big number is not too important. If you put parentheses around every pair of numbers, I have no choice unless I do something really weird and ignore the parentheses, basically. I have to do it in that order. Kyler?
Well, is there ever a time where you have parentheses around parentheses?
Yeah.
You do here?
No, I meant like 2 parentheses, like.
Yeah. It should be. I mean, it's just kind of redundant. It's not wrong. It's just so if I had like 2 times 3 plus 4, okay.
No,
I want you to add 3 to 4 parentheses around that. But if I put parentheses around that,
yeah,
it's just like super parentheses. It doesn't really do anything, right?
Oh,
I do this, right, and I get 7, and the 7's inside the parentheses. You know, that tells me to multiply.
Yeah.
But so did this little dot. Right there.
Okay.
So if I put parentheses around parentheses, I'm just doing more than I need to. It's like, it's not like putting a box in a box.
Yeah.
But it kind of is like that. There's
yeah.
just nothing inside the parentheses, but just one set of parentheses. But if we have multiple parentheses inside parentheses, that makes sense, because I just want to prioritize even within the parentheses. Right?
Well, couldn't you do like, you could do like 2 times, so like 2 times, and then parentheses, and then like 3 times parentheses, and then like 4 plus 5,
mm-hmm.
and then parenthesis, and then there's parenthesis around that. You can do that too, right?
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so you do the 4+5 first.
That does not require PEMDAS. I don't need any PEMDAS to tell me what order to do these things in, because the parentheses put every pair of numbers together that I want you to do in a particular order. Okay? I want you to add 4+5 first. There's just, if we're on opposite sides of a debate and you try to tell me that I'm not supposed to add 4 and 5 before anything else, your position would be hard to argue. It'd be hard for you to argue that you're not supposed to add 4 or 5 first. I that person use parentheses.
Was that you're supposed to add it first?
Right. So for me to say like, oh no, what I'm supposed to do is 3 times 4, get 12, and then add 5. That's just a ridiculous idea.
Yeah.
Add 4 and 5 first, and you get 9. Okay. Then clearly you want me to do 3 times 9, and that's 27. And then you want me to multiply 27 times 2, 4. Now in this case, whether I multiply 3 times 9 or 2 times 3 first. Doesn't make a difference. It does make a difference up here whether I add the 4 and the 5 or if I multiply by 3. You see what I'm saying? So the parentheses make PEMDAS obsolete. So why don't we just use a bunch of parentheses?
Because it wouldn't work out like that.
It's just pointless.
It's pointless
unless you really want to do it for a certain reason.
So you're saying using all the parentheses is somehow not as good. Why is it not as good? What's better about PEMDAS than just using a bunch of parentheses?
Oh,
yeah.
It simplifies it.
It's a little simpler. Like, it looks a little cluttered and busy, and it's just all these parentheses everywhere. It's doing its job, but then it's all messy. What if we agree that certain things come before other things, and then we can get rid of some of those parentheses? Unless we want to go out of order, then we need to use those parentheses to say go out of order. Okay? Danielle?
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Good.
What's the point of parentheses?
Just tell you if you
group like
things together.
I know, but like
I want you to
G
plus.
If you had that, if you had 48 divided by 2 times 9+3, you would know what to do.
Okay, let's use this as an example. If I just put numbers and operations, then...
Oh, I get it. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
To get you to add 4 and 5 to get 9, I have to force you to do that out of order according to PEMDAS, right? Mm-hmm. Out of that order. Because if I just write it like this, 2 times 3 times 4 plus 5, the order PEMDAS would tell us to do 2 times 3 is 6, times 4 is 24, and then add 5 to the PEMDAS. Mm-hmm. Once you go out of order, force you to do that with parentheses. So now we need much fewer parentheses if we use PEMDAS in order. Okay? Now, there is no universal order. There's no order that everyone worldwide agrees to. It's just that's the nature of the thing. In the early 20th century, the early 1900s, when they started printing textbooks, right, and they were trying to educate people in the same way, around at least this country, that's when we started to say we should all be using kind of the same order. Kind of like we try to all use feet and inches, or we all try to use, we all use Fahrenheit, right? We use the same kind of measurement, use the same kind of process, the same order here, so that everybody kind of is in agreement. Clint?
What do they do in Europe? Do they like do like something else first?
Europe, in some places, it seems like, I have not done my like due diligence and researched this a lot, but from discussions I've seen online, videos and stuff, it seems like there's some people in Europe that use something called BOD, and I forget what O stands for. This stands for bracket. O, something like exponents.
Odd mass?
I can't remember what O stands for.
Oh.
But D is for division, M is for multiplication, A is for addition, S is for subtraction. And depending on who you ask, they may say, always do division first. Always, always, always. Even if there's other multiplication, do division first. Always, then multiply. Okay. Like when we look at PEMDAS, some people say, Always, but and comes first. Always do multiplication first and division comes next. That's not what we're going to do, but that's what some people say. Because n comes first. Okay? There's no reason why you shouldn't do that, other than there's plenty of people who don't. Right? So let's get on the same page. That's all we're trying to do here, get on the same page. And what we're going to do here in a minute, make sure we're all on the same page. Okay? But,
oh, so you just want to be left to right for multiplication and division?
We are going to in this class.
Okay.
And most classes do this. Most American classes do it that way. Most standardized tests, like the VAN expression, they would expect you to do it that way, left to right, multiplication and division at the same time from left to right.
Okay.
So a lot of people have agreed to use this order. And I'm going to write it like this. I think this is the way Mr. Lilly had it in his room. I'm copying it from him. You saw there. Like this. You see nothing for in his room hanging up?
No.
No.
Who?
No, no.
Mr. Lilly?
I didn't have him.
Yeah, but it wasn't.
So, the nice thing about this is top to bottom, right? Top is first, bottom's last. But by putting multiplication and division, it's just a reminder that the order we're going to use is multiplication and division from left to right. If division comes first, and there's also multiplication, do the division that's on the left before you do the multiplication. So, we back up to this first thing. Without a parenthesis, and now we do have PEMDAS, we do have this order that we decided we're going to agree to, then those parentheses would be implied because division goes from left to right. Do 6 divided by 3 first. Why are we doing 6 divided by 3 first? Left to right, it's on the left. And then all there is to just divide by 3. Here, we've got, you know, if we didn't have these parentheses, as it was to start with, 48 divided by 2 first. Why do I do that before I multiply by what's in this parentheses?
Left
to right, multiplication and division from left to right. Okay, simple left to right.
First,
right. But I could add these together and divide this at the same time.
Yeah.
Right.
It doesn't really matter.
First.
But.
But yeah, we make sure we do the parentheses. When you say parentheses first, we just mean parentheses beats everything. If something's in parentheses, do the parentheses. Don't ignore the parentheses. Okay?
Yeah.
It's almost silly that P is part of this thing. What's that? Okay.
I'm listening now.
What it sounds like?
Can we go back to that?
Oh, yes, we can. Huh?
That's what we're trying to learn, right?
That's what we're trying
to learn. Yeah, that's what we're learning. This. Cool.
But if he's teaching it in a different way that is more
structured.
Or understanding.
Understand
these are things that I see errors all the time. And to not talk about it would just be to say, well, too bad for those of you who are still confused about it and still do things out of order, or don't understand why we have fractions the way we do, or how to multiply fractions, or whatever. Okay? And to create the situation where we're supposed to use multiplication of fractions, and we never understood how to do it in the first place. Okay? So while some of us may do just fine, others need a little reminder, that's what this is about. Using the order that we just discussed, works this out. If we didn't have an order, there'd be absolutely no reason for me to do it in any particular order. Couple these up any way I want to, but because multiplication and division come first, there's some implied parentheses there, and that way we can just all get the same answer. It's not so that we can be right, so that we can standardize the answer we should get. Not in the same way that they have, like, the Olympics, sports Olympics, but they have competitions that they call Math Olympics.
Huh.
It's not like they have a worldwide competition where people come from all countries to
I should
try that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put, listen, please. I'm going to add the parentheses back in that have been removed, okay? Like basically, write this problem in a way as if there weren't. Okay. So
according to that order, what I'm saying is I want you to do this first. So I want you to do that, those together. Okay. When I get those, I'm going to want you to, if we're being really strict, add these from left to right, add these together. You're going to add that onto that. And we're going to add that onto whatever we got there. And then like we're going to wind up with one number here and one number here. We're going to subtract those two numbers.
Yeah, the answer is 20.
That's interesting. 20. Okay. 18 divided by 3 is 6. I also have a parenthesis with just two numbers in it. I can add those together. 3. Plus 3. Plus 20. All those are together. Let's see. This 3 plus 3, that's together in this parenthesis. That's 6.
Dang it.
Plus 20 in here. Minus 6.
20. 26.
Minus
6.
Yeah.
Is it all right if we got the same answer but then in a different way?
I guess it depends. Sometimes you do something that's definitely false and happen to get the right answer, and sometimes you just do it in a slightly different order.
And I thought I...
Yeah, 20 minus 6 is 14. That's fine.
And then I did 1 plus 2. And then just went from left to right there.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't draw any brackets. I'm just like.
Well, that's fine. I'm just making it very clear what I was about to do, right? What
okay.
order I was about to follow. So, with this one, let me just point something out. Without parentheses and without an order that we all agree on, there's no reason why I shouldn't do 3 times 4 is 12. And then take 12 and square it. The reason why we don't do that is because we all agreed not to. Okay? By the order of operations, quote, the order of operations, we decided, let's not do that first. Let's always agree that if there's an exponent on a number, we'll do that first. All right, this time I'm going to do it just by, you know, step by step, not going to put parentheses around it. Follow that order we agreed to. So according to that order, what should I do first?
Exponents.
Exponents first. So the exponent 4 to the second power is what?
16.
Careful, not 8. Some people multiply by 2 there. It's multiplied by itself. Okay. What comes next? Yeah? Okay, well, we're going to multiply what? 16, that's 48. Any other multiplication or division that we should do?
15 divided by
5. Before we multiply by 3, right? Because from left to right,
yeah.
So plus 3 times 3 minus 7. What next? 48
plus 9.
Plus 9 minus 7 equals 50.
So 48 plus 9 from left to right is 57. Now, that'd be very, very strict, strictly following the order of operations that we agreed on. Good? But, I mean, could I have at this step, could I do 48 minus 7 here?
No.
Let's see. What's 48 minus 7? 48 minus 7?
41.
41. Plus 9. What's 41 plus 9? 50.
But it just doesn't seem right. We're not going to left to right.
Was it wrong?
No.
Was I just lucky?
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I was just making random guesses. Maybe I was lucky, but I knew that, yes, I could look into the future and see that this number here is going to be 9, and whether I add 48 plus 9 and subtract 7, it's the same as if I take 48 and subtract 7 from it and add 9. Does that make a difference? So that order also is not like the law, and if you go out of order in any way at all, you get a different answer. You get the same answer. Kyler just a while ago did something in a slightly different order. You didn't go left to right. You went to the very end and you did the subtraction first, it was on the right, and then you could, but it doesn't make a difference in that case.
Which one did I do?
Look at the one that we just did at the very right side somewhere there. You did the subtraction towards the right side.
1 plus 2. 10 plus 3 plus 4 times 5 is 18 divided by 3.
Whatever one we just did before this.
was the one you asked me if.
20 minus 6, you did.
Oh, yeah.
That's technically out of order of being left to right.
Yeah.
But it doesn't make a difference. That would give you the exact same thing every time.
It just seems like it's better because, like, it's the biggest number on there and you're taking it into the.
Yeah, sure. That makes a lot of sense. I mean, it's a little easier. 9 minus 7. Let's just take care of that subtraction with these little numbers. 9 minus 7 is 2. 48 plus 2?
Yeah.
Also 50.
Yeah.
You know what
I'm
saying?
Either way, you get the right answer.
Either way, you get the same answer as I got, right? Or the same answer as a person who follows PEMDAS strictly.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
Because this is a property of addition, if we look at this as plus negative 7, of addition called associativity. It doesn't matter if I do 48 plus 9 first or 9 minus 7 first, I get the exact same answer. I did this first, and over here, 48 plus 2, still 50, still the same answer.
Why aren't we doing the same stuff as the other
elementals?
Because we all need it.
Yeah.
Why are you doing the same stuff?
We're not.
How are you not?
Oh, because they had this homework assignment?
Yeah, but they had like a bunch of other stuff.
Because they were just at a place where it was appropriate.
They were ready to take home a little bit of an assignment.
Did you guys read in that class? What happened to you? So we get 50 either way, whether we do 57 minus 7 or we do 48 plus 2, it's the same. That's all for order of operations.
So the thing I'm trying to do there is show you,
I write something on a test, or in your homework, or whatever, and I can bet that this book does the same thing, follows the same order. That's the order that I'm going to follow. It's the order that I expect you to follow, so we get the same answers, and I don't have to use a bunch of parentheses. That's all that's about. You can see here, today's the 15th, 16th tomorrow. We're going to do a little test, and we're going to do with the rest of class now. I'm going to hand out a little review.
Just a review.
It's just to help you study, to help you review. This is not a test that you have to take right now. Worried. He's
out. Is this work?
It's not an assignment that you have to do, or else you'll get no credit. But the remainder of this class and all classes, I'll expect you to be productive. If you can be productive in another way, study a different way, that's fine.